Hi, welcome to the class. In the last class, we discussed about an important aspect of uniform circular motion, and we talked about the centripetal force. Now today, we'll continue with an important force, which is centrifugal force. So centripetal, as I told you, is essential to keep a body moving in a circular path. And the direction of this force is always towards the center. So, centrifugal force acts towards the center of the circle in which the body is moving. So this is centripetal force. Now what about the centrifugal force? So centrifugal force, so suppose we have merry-go-round, and the person standing here, and this person is going rotating in the merry-go-round and going through a circular path. And the person is being tied with a thread. The person who is standing here can see this person moving in the circular path, rotating in the circular path, and this person will say that this person is experiencing a centripetal force towards the center of the circle, as this person is being tied with a thread, and the tension in the thread is providing this necessary centripetal force. So this will happen, this person will say this, who is standing outside the merry-go-round and just watching the person going in the circular motion. Now for someone who is standing here and looking at this person, so this person, since this person is tied with the spring and one more person standing here, so when they will rotate, what will happen? This person and this person will be looking at each other and will be in a straight line of motion, facing each other. So now, for this merry-go-round will rotate, this person will change its position, and so this person will also come again face to face. So it will keep on going like this, this person. So what happens is, when we cut the thread for this person, this object, as we discussed in the last class, when we cut the thread, at any point the velocity is acting along the tangential direction, so the body will start moving along the tangent. So this person will say, oh, this is the velocity, this is the component of the velocity, and that's why the person is moving along the tangential direction. But this, how this person will perceive the motion of this person? So this person will perceive the motion of this person, as I told you, they will be facing each other. In this case, when the thread is being cut, in that case also, they will be facing each other, and this person will be going away from this person. Away means in the outward direction from the center, it will be going like this. So first this person will see this person here, then here, then here, and then here. So this person will say, now there is no tension in the spring, so there is no centripetal force. So the person who is sitting at the center will say that there is an outward force which is being act on this person, and the person is going away. So that force is centrifugal force, but actually it is a fictitious force. It's not an actual force, because you know that from this reference point, the person is going away because there is a component of velocity in that direction. But for this person is going away as if he's being pushed out away from the center. And that is why this person is going away from the center. So this person will say that a force is being experienced by this person and moving away from the center. So this is centrifugal force, and it acts away from the center. Now we'll do an activity demonstrating centrifugal force. Okay, now in this activity, as you can see, this is a wooden stand on which a circular disc is being fixed. The circular disc can rotate, and there's a platform which is being made. So the person who is standing outside the merry-go-round is this person. So I have used a candle to demonstrate three people, one person standing outside the merry-go-round, and two person are rotating nicely inside the merry-go-round. This is the center of the merry-go-round. You can see these two persons are facing each other at each and every point. So what happens is, when they rotate nicely, this person will say there is a centripetal force which is being acting on these two people rotating in merry-go-round, and this is acting because they are being tied with a thread, and there is a tension in the thread. Because of that, a centripetal force is being provided, and that is why they are moving. Now, if the thread is being cut, and suppose this person, a thread is being cut, now what will happen? As I rotate the disc, what will happen as I rotate the disc? So if I rotate the disc like this, so this person will start falling out. Why? Because the component of the velocity is along the tangential direction. So this person will fall in the tangential direction. But for this person, he'll not fall in the tangential direction, as when we rotate it, this person will be going like this away from this person. And this person will feel that this object or this person is being pushed away from the center. So that is why for this person, a force, a fictitious force is being acting on this person, which is the centrifugal force. But actually, for this person who is standing outside the merry-go-round, there is no centrifugal force as such. But the person is going away because there is a component of velocity in that direction, that is the tangential direction. So let me demonstrate it to you. So when it goes down, so it goes like this for this person, like this, but for this person it goes in a tangential direction. So let me rotate this and then put the candle. So as you can see, it went like this. So it is going in the tangential direction because there is a component of velocity. Once more, I'll show it to you. So it goes like this because there is a component of the velocity there, and that is actually what is happening. But for this person, for this frame of reference, there is a centrifugal force which is being acting. So it's not a real force, it's a fictitious force. Thank you.